Sanjay Dhariwal is already a brand in Jito. You all know that he is a director. He is our director at Jito Apex and also secretary at Jito Apex. And he sits in a number of Jain organizations as a member in other group of institutions. Member of FKCCI State Taxes Committee, member of Fiscal Laws Committee as formed by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, member of Indirect Tax Committee of ICAI Delhi, member in Commercial Taxes Consultative Committee of the Commercial Taxes Department at Karnataka. Basically, as a chartered accountant, he is a well-known VAT consultant in Karnataka, and also he has written a number of books on value-added tax and commercial taxes, and he writes periodicals regularly in leading newspapers like Times of India, The Canara, and Indian Express, and he is a partner of Sanjay Dhariwal and Srinivas, a chartered accountant consultancy. And Sanjay is also a graduate in law, and he has Bangalore University and completed his articleship under Kiran Jinnahar. And he has got a lot of hidden talent within, which we are trying to pull out now from him. And I'd like to welcome Mr. Sanjay Dhariwal to the class.
Before I start on the subject proper, let me at least give you a background how this topic came up across. I think, how many of you knew Himmat before this session today, or before this call was made? Hardly four or five people. So Himmat wanted to speak on this topic, and we thought for Jito it would be a great topic to talk about. So what Himmat did, he wanted to brand himself in Jito, he wanted to speak in Jito. Sorry Himmat, it's just going out of the way just for the sake of humor. So what he did is, he said that okay fine, let's have another speaker who's going to speak on this topic, probably because of whom people would also come. So he said, Sanjay, tag on to this. My area of specialization is not branding at all. I don't do any areas of consulting in the field of branding. I've been just tagged on to Himmat so that you all could come over here for the session. Okay, so that's a good way of branding yourself with another brand or whatever you call it, so that you have this, so that first the Jito MC gives us an opportunity to present the matter here. Others they would say, Himmat, pehle ek baar hum log test karenge, aap kaise ho, phir denge. Then the name came with Sanjay, so probably Rajendra ji said, theek hai, bolne do. Okay, so yeah.
You went a step further, Modi ka naam liya.
The second brand he used is a brand which attracted you all, ki Modi style. So then you thought that probably how do you use this Modi style into your own businesses. And then next is the making of a personal and a professional brand. How many of you believe you have a brand? You have your own personal brand. Yes, all of you have a brand. What do you brand yourself as? Yeah.
I do electronics.
Okay.
So it's, I have not marketed myself anywhere. It's been an invento based window from 7 years. And it's from word to word, word to my, it's my, that my company name is Sai Infocom. But you can know me from Ravi. Ravi ke paas jao.
Okay. So you have your own personal image or a personal name as far as your customers are concerned. Anybody outside your customer segment, do they know you? I'll just give you a simple example. I'll talk more about myself today because I thought that that's the easiest way to see what exactly a brand could be changing across. 5 years back, most of all of us are Jains over here. 5 years or 6 years back, how many of you knew Sanjay Dhariwal? Hardly. You are my classmates, so you know it. But a few of them are the clients. But majority of them did not know Sanjay Dhariwal. Reason what? He was a Jain. I had the same knowledge of VAT as I had around 20 years back or 15 years back or 10 years back when VAT law was implemented. But I was not known amongst the Jain community. So what I did? I felt that I should brand myself in the Jain community. I should be known to the Jain community. After all, that is my family. So how do I brand myself in the Jain community? So the one way was to join Jito, the other way was to join Therapan Professional Forum. So both these places, I'm sure Gautamji Kotari, who is the president of the Therapan Samaj here, he is also present here. 5 years back, he did not know who Sanjay Dhariwal was. Not at all. And they were surprised when my name was proposed even for the national president of Therapan Professional Forum. Because I was not known in my own circle here in the own city in which I stayed across. Ramesh did not know Sanjay. Now we are very close friends, we are part of the Adarsh College. So these are the three institutes which I got joined across. I joined the Adarsh College group, I joined the Dehradun Professional Forum, I joined the JITO, and suddenly I started realizing that in the Jain community I am known and people know me. And I know lots of things. And that gives me a lot of pleasure. My whole objective of joining these three particular organizations was not to brand myself. My objective of joining these three organizations was not to promote my profession. Because I always felt my money comes more from non-Jains because they pay well. Okay. And my branding was always going to be as on brand. But today if you see, out of the last around 40-50 talks I have given in the last 3 years, I have hardly spoken on VAT or around 5 or 6 places, except when I go for the training to the Commercial Taxes Department or the CA Association. I hardly speak in social sectors today on my subject, which is my main subject is VAT. Today I speak more on other subjects. It could be on delegation, it is on time sharing, it could be on society, it could also mean on the spiritual courses, etc. But I would hardly speak on my core subject, which is that. So today when you talk about Sanjay, or anywhere you go around, simplicity, every time promoting people coming across. Change your brand. You take another film for this purpose, a personality called Amjad Khan. Amjad Khan was known as what? Gabban Singh. He was known for all the negative roles. But in a movie like Kurbani, what did he do? He came out with a very positive role. He changed his brand. Today, Sanjeev Kumar, when you went for any movie of Sanjeev Kumar, you were not really trying to say that action movie is going to be a humor, it's going to be a serious movie, or it's going to be a love story. Today they have huge budgets for branding, but many a times we have also seen that branding can also come with lots of disabilities, it can also come with lots of problems, and you have to be very clear of what you want to brand. And the cost involved for branding is also an important area which you'll have to look across. And when you're talking about a personal brand, it's very easy. I'll just give you a simple example. You take Prakash Singh, you take Tel Raji, you take Rajendraji Gandhi, these are the brands of Ajinko Bangalore, right? All of you agree?
Yes.
Okay. Today, the biggest problem with them for branding themselves so strong is that every other organization will go to them and say, Rajendra bhai, hum ye particular social kaam kar rahe, 50 lakh ka chanda de do, 1 crore ka chanda de do, 2 crore ka chanda de do. And these things would be that aap maan ke diye humko kyun nahi de rahe ho, hamare samaj ko kyun nahi de rahe ho. And this is also going to be a disadvantage when it comes to personal branding, because then it is very difficult to live to your own expectations. So you have to be careful when you brand. When you brand yourself as a donor, you have to be very careful ke haan, har ek jagah aapko taaliyan to milegi, but uske saath aapko so jane aur milenge jo kahenge, hamare liye bhi kuch kar do. So you have to also be very careful when you're branding yourself across. So whether most of us believe that we should brand ourselves, we should be good. But then this is the thing. Again, many times we feel that by branding, we should also have excellent clothing, etc., which we have. We should have the best watches, we should have the best dresses, we should have the best branded clothes, a best branded pen, etc., etc., and all that. But today, I am telling you one thing very frankly, if Amir Khan wears an ordinary chappal also, you would think it is a very expensive chappal. If I and me are wearing the most costly shoes and the slippers across and we go anywhere, people would not suspect that, they would not think, mostly, ye kya naam hoga, pirated hoga or something which is being used across. The same example, a man who goes to a 5-star hotel, even if he has a duplicate pen, it would look as though it's an original pen. But if you are going to a canteen of Brahmin's coffee bar, which is a very popular coffee bar over here, it's a branded coffee bar here. Don't go to the Brahmin's at Jainagar or JP Nagar, which is open. That is not part of the Brahmin's coffee bar. Okay, that's what he clarified yesterday. Okay, the reason why I'm trying to say is that when you go to a Brahmin's coffee bar, even if you're having a 50,000 rupees pen, Mobla, you're having it, or Mont Blanc, what we call it across, people would say, ye toh khala 500-600 ka pen hoga, aise hi dikha rahe logo ka. So the place where you're going also matters, the group what you're going also matters, and branding can also be positive, it could also be negative. But what is the real benefits of branding? It helps you develop a strong network. It helps you create. Today, if you're branded very strongly across, in the community of yours, anywhere you go, you can basically have friends to help you out. You can also get a discount. If today you have to get something and you have a brand and you know Rajendra, you can always call him up and say, "Wow, stove top ka cooker bhej do itna mein," and basically you'll get your discounts also. So most important, there's a constant flow of business and increases the earning potential. Branding can help you basically get your good earning. And I would say that branding, as a professional I'm concerned, this is something very, very important for me. Like as a chartered accountant today, if I'm speaking on a subject called brand and I say I'm a useless person on this brand, I've just been tagged on to a Himmel, okay, but then you'll ask me that what is the subject I specialize on. I'll give you a classical example. I've gone to Times of India around 15 years back to deliver lecture on wealth management. And after the whole session was over for the staff of the Times of India, I said that this is not my area of specialization. My area of specialization is sales tax. After that, they had a problem in sales tax, and then the finance head said, if he could speak on wealth management well, that means on VAT and sales tax, he would definitely be a better person. So we went across to him. So when you brand yourself, try and basically focus what your strength is, not on the subjects which you are not very good at. On the other hand, if you are branding yourself well, if you are networking yourself well, and if you are able to project yourself that you are good in a particular subject, I am sure Dinesh Bhai is present over here. The brand really helps in getting new clients. Right, Dinesh Bhai?
Yes, sir.
And as professional, as a doctor today, if you have created a brand, okay, if you go to this particular doctor, you'll be able to run like P.T. Usha in the olden days, or like the flying Sikh, that is Milkha Singh. Even if your knees are going to be having a problem, you could get your knees replaced across. He's a person who also deals with sports stars, is dealing with cricketers. You basically change your perception and say, no, that's a safe place to go across. And that is what brand can basically get you across. What do people say about brand? Your brand is what people say about you when you are not in the room. Today, when you are out of the room, when you are not available in a particular group of friends, etc., and you are not in the social area, when people talk good about you and not bad about you, it is normally seen that majority of us praise every other person we meet when we meet him in person. But when the person is not there, we always end to crib about him, we end up criticizing them across, we do not talk about them. So the person should be missed across, the person should be highlighted, and this is what the founder of Amazon has said. In my personal opinion, create your own brand and let it be unique. Whenever you're creating your brand, you should be unique, you should be different. But again, you should not be in a person who is not approachable. You should be somebody whom the other person who is dealing with you should be able to link. Like Rajendra Ji said, that it may be a very big brand as far as Pigeon is concerned, but then he wants it to be related to the ideally the middle class housewives to say that this is my product, this is what it is, and it is value for money which I'm looking out there. Similarly, even in individuals today, for a simple example, today you talk about a leading chartered accountant, like if you talk about the Nani Palkhiwala, the late advocate, who was the master in his subject. He was brilliant. But how many of us over here, if we had a serious problem, could afford to go to Nani Palkhiwala? No. Why? He was too expensive. He was brilliant, no doubt, but too expensive. But today, at times, I believe that you should price yourself a little high so that people know that you have a valuable existence in the market. On the other hand, you should also see to it that you don't overprice yourself, that the other person is hesitant. That is what Mr. Gandhi said, that out of a product which is sold at 100 rupees, if the other person can afford it only at 90, you sell it at 90. So that what happens is that you are able to link yourself up to the particular product or to the particular person and you can go across. Many of us would always have a hesitation, ye itna bada advocate hai, ye itna bada chartered accountant hai, itna bada doctor hai, mera chota sa problem mein dekhega kya? And the other problems which we also try to do when we are talking about the personal branding is that we have to also be careful about. Many a times, when I was young in practice, I always used to say, mere paas time nahi hai. What was the indication I used to give them? I used to give an indication to say, I'm not having time because I'm busy, I'm getting lots of work. Today, if I still retain the same tagline to say, mere paas time nahi hai, people will say, Sanjay ke paas time nahi hai, client banne ki zarurat nahi hai, dusre ke paas chalte hai. Because as a chartered accountant, if you do not have your time, then you are definitely not able to service your client well. You are not going to listen to what your client wants to say. So this is also very important. So today I have changed my tagline to say, I don't work, I've got a lot of time. So you can always come to me. And believe me, Jito permits you to market yourself because it is a business forum wherein you basically do a J2J, and therefore I'm not doing anything unethical. Now, exactly how do you create your personal brand? Okay, define your brand and become an expert. Now, discover what you are, what you want to do, and what you are good at. Today, if Sanjay Sisodia does the JCL, I cannot be part of JCL just because I'm not, I want to also brand myself as a good cricketer. I cannot be a Robin Uthappa, I cannot be a Rohit Sharma, I cannot be a Rahul Dravid, or I cannot be a Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar cannot be a good actor. It's a fact. So he has to limit himself when he comes into an advertisement also. He limits himself to very limited dialogues because that is not his strength. So basically you have to understand, discover who you are. If Sachin is a good cricketer, you would brand him to cricket. So silently he could sell his gold coins and silver coins. Because there he doesn't have to speak. His only picture is put across over there. Then what do you want to do? Today, if I want to brand myself as Mr. Rajendra Gandhi, but I don't want to give donations, people would not come to me. Then the next is, and what you are good at. If Himmat is a good speaker, and he has a specializes in offline marketing, or online branding, online marketing, etc., he should focus on those areas of branding, online marketing. He should not be taking up subjects of VAT and income tax, etc., which he does not have the specialization, because then his brand value would come down drastically. Then next is, once you have figured out what you want to do, work on your strengths and try to perfect the same. You have to select the subjects which you are good at. And one of the important areas of what you, this thing, this, that what is your strength and try to perfect the same, is that you have to basically be a good learner. Believe me, friends, that if I have spoken on more than 1,000 seminars and conferences across, around 995 conferences and seminars, people will come and tell you, Sanjay, you spoke very well. Very rarely do people come and tell you on the face that you spoke bad. But that should not be taken as your thing to say that I've achieved a lot. You should ask people who can tell you in private to say where you were wrong, what was bad about it, and where you can improve it across. And this is where it will help you create your branding. You'll have to do a lot of research into it to see that what is that which I'm lacking across, where I have to improve across, and where I have to add more value across, otherwise I'm not going to have the same brand value. So you have to look into this. Today, if NC is over here, Narendra Chaurasia is here, he's got a brand called as InString. He basically deals with products which are more used by the young ladies, right? Can see? Okay. So basically what happens is that he has to do a lot of research across to find out that what are the products he is doing, what are the accessories that a woman wants. And this is what is a daily research which you'll have to do, add value to it across. And this is the place where we have to be very careful that what do I want to be. Today, if he starts keeping suits, etc., and all that, and you're going to have men and ladies being there, many of his products the ladies will not come and buy because men would be around. So these are the areas you have to be very clear what you want to do, and you have to set your goal, write your vision, and then make the personal brand statement. And many a times what happens is, we are very good at this level, setting up your goals. You write down your missions. But very few of us are good executors in seeing that you are executing your basically mission and seeing that you are achieving it across. So one of the branding is basically saying that the respect what you get from the people is most important, that is most important. Now, generate brand and awareness through networking. I think this is one of the places which I would like to focus more. Now, most of you know Mr. Chengachania, right? Okay, no harms meant. He's my brother, so I can take a little leverage of adding on something. Now, supposing I meet 100 new people daily, and you probably meet 5 new people daily. If I praise those 100 people daily, what are you going to do in return for me? You're also going to praise me across. Right? Or no?
Yes.
If I'm going to praise Rajendra Gandhi on this platform, so the moment I sit down, he'll also say, Sanjay is a great speaker. And I'm praising him because he started praising me when the session was about to start. Okay, but if I criticize a person, I say T.C. Mehta is a bad person, he's a professional, because we are competitors, we deal with the same clients, then what will happen? T.C. Mehta is also going to criticize me. So what we should do is that if you want to create a brand in your own networks and outside your networks also, try to praise as much as people because the quality is what they are. Don't overpraise. Don't say, Lalita Pawar, you look as good as Aishwarya Rai. Right? But also you can be fair enough to say the good qualities, because every human being has a good quality. If you are able to identify those good qualities and start telling them that yes, this is good. I'll give you a live example. If you are going for online branding, you post a photograph of yours and you are not active on Facebook, how many likes will you get? Hardly anything. On the other hand, you become like Mr. Sajan Raj Mehta. He likes every photograph, he likes anything, he gives a comment everywhere, he would feedback, he would do it across, and you see the number of likes he gets when he puts his photograph. It's equivalent to every girl who uploads a photograph of us. Normally a girl always gets an upload and a like irrespective of the photo being good or bad. But for a gentleman it is always difficult. So these are the levels that if you are basically looking at a very different area, when you network with people, when you meet people, you try to do that. The second important area is when you are networking with people, try to see if you could help them out. Many of us meet across lots of people, we go to too many social organizations, etc. But we are not that helpful, we are not that. If somebody says something, you say, yeah, I'll come back to you. If they ask you a question, you say that you'll come back to you. How many of them respond back to you without you calling them and asking them, ki aap Sanjay ji, aapne ye bola tha, ye karne ka hai, ye hua ke nahi hua, aap ye details dene wale the, hua ke nahi hua. The day you call back and tell people, your response time is good. Like today, if you get a call from somebody, you respond back to that particular call. This would actually help you develop a better brand in the market. If NC has, I have called up NC and NC is not responded, that means he's busy in a seminar, conference or with a client, he will come back to me later. And if I have given this work to Mahesh, I'm sure it's going to be delivered. I don't have to have an issue. So this is the sort of branding that we'll have to create amongst ourselves, that today we network well, we basically, and we also try to promote. Many a times what happens is that we blindly say, ye aapko jute kharidna, bata chale jao, idhar chale jao. If you're not aware of that particular level, if you do not know the real good qualities, if your strength is not that particular level, try to avoid recommending those particular products also. Many a times as professionals we have seen that I don't deal in central excise and VAG. Or central excise and FEMA, etc. If anybody comes to me, I would say, you can go to this man, you can go to this man. Many a times I would do that just because I would be probably getting a kickback or a fees from the other person as a referral fee across, that you basically refer it across. No. You first see that if you refer that particular person, is that guy going to deliver what the person is looking out for, whether the other person is ethical or not. You have to do your research as far as your networking is concerned. It is also very important whom you know. When you're branding yourself, many times you come across people who says, I know Devegowda, I know Jagdish Shetter, I know Edurappa, I know the present CM, Siddaramaiah, etc. and all that stuff. But when it comes to the real deliverables, you suddenly say, nahi, wo abhi nahi hai, mera aadmi jo tha, wo yaha nahi hai, abhi uske saath dosti nahi hai, and all that stuff. So basically, you also, when you brand yourself well, you be clear of what you are talking. You should have those connections, you should have those people across when you're talking it about. And attend events which matter to you. Today, if you want to promote your business, if you want to network with your business, be into the program which Jito is organizing on the business events. It would help you in branding yourself, it would help you in knowing that you are into the business segment, you are into businesses, and it would also help you in basically networking with people, because all of them coming for a business seminar are coming with a common purpose. It's not necessary that I should attend a Diwali get-together, because Diwali get-together is a family event where the families meet across and all that, but that I would not be branding myself as a man interested in business. I don't say that won't come. Okay? But this is what I personally feel, is that meeting and selecting the right topics, meeting and selecting the right, basically selecting the right speakers across, and basically going for those subjects which are going to influence you, which are going to help you across, is something that you'll have to look across to be branding. And when you're talking about a personal brand, there should be clarity. You should not be saying one thing today and the other thing tomorrow. Today I should not be telling him that, look, we should have lots of programs on B2B. And tomorrow if I say, Mr. Gandhi, that B2B programs are all fine, but cost cutting kijiye, aap 10 ke badle 3 program hi kijiye. No, we should have clarity. Any work we do, or any leaders which we look across, we should have clarity. Today, Modi says many things to us. He says of Swachh Bharat. Our president also is having a program of basically cleaning Bangalore. Okay, but Modi has a program of Swachh Bharat. Now just imagine that when you're talking about Swachh Bharat, if Narendra Modi takes a bottle of water, drinks it and throws it on the ground, would you call that this man is the brand image for Swachh Bharat? No. And today, when a person is basically cleaning the grounds and basically the photographs are coming of all the celebrities, and after that you come to know that basically dust was thrown over there so that they could clean it across, would it basically be linked to a Swachh Bharat agenda? No. So today we have to be very careful that what we are talking about, we are clear about it. The next is that we should be consistent. Not that we cannot change if our perception changes, but then we should consistently not be changing. That's very essential. And today, as a personality, I would always say that you should basically be clear about what your perception is and what you basically are looking at, and don't be changing your statements. Don't be saying, today I say Om is a great man, tomorrow I say Mahesh is a great man, and when I meet Mahesh, I say Om to Osala Bekar Admi. See, we have to be clear. We have to be very positive about what we are doing about, and we have to be constant in whatever we are doing. And this would help us in basically our personal branding. This is something which I have always been believing in, particularly if you are a professional and you want to brand yourself. 80% of the professionals, I can assure you, would not respond back to your call, would not respond back to the time when they are saying that I will deliver this on this particular time that it happens. I think most of you are from the business lines, you have dealt with all the professionals, you would have realized that the professionals don't respond back. Many of the business people also today would not respond back and say that yes, this is what it is. I believe that if you have the habit of responding back to people, if you have the habit back of basically going back and saying, yes, this is what you have said, I don't say everybody would be on time. I don't say that everybody would deliver on time. But I always believe that if you cannot deliver on time, I can at least intimate my clients to say that I'm not able to deliver it today, and that would have a very different brand value. That yes, X is a perfectionist, but also he delivers on time, and if he is not delivering on time, I would get a call, so I can be rest assured that if he is not called up, that means he is going to deliver it to me. I think this is another area where we can basically work on, and I'm sure most of us could do this. Listen to people and you might get new opportunities. Many a times what happens when we go to meet people or we meet new people across, we start talking about, main ye kar raha hu, main wo kar raha hu, main ye kar raha hu, ye aisa karta hu, waisa karta hu. By boasting about yourself, by talking about yourself, you are creating a little bit of brand value in him. But on the other hand, you are also making him get negative about you, ki ye sala bahut baat karta. Right or wrong? So what we have to do is that, number one, if we can learn to listen. I know some of the very leading guys in the world today, when they go for parties, they ask them that, can you please give me the list of the people who are attending the party? They ask the secretaries to basically Google and find out who are the type of people who are coming for the party, what is the profile, who is doing what. Today, if I meet Hitesh in a party, and for the first time I am meeting Hitesh now in the party, and I tell him, hi Hitesh, how are you? So you basically deal in spices, you deal with cardamom, you deal with olive. So basically what happens? He is going to be thrilled. One way of impressing a person is doing your research, and as Himmat asked, how many of you don't use Google? I think if you ask me, most of us do not use Google for what it is actually meant for. If we are able to Google across, develop our knowledge, know across. Like today, if I knew that there are around 125 people coming for this program, and what is the basic quality or the profile of the people, if I would have done my research and come across, and then I could have spoken on examples which are very important. Otherwise, I'm using the same 8-10 names who I basically want to link to. Right? But on the other hand, if you want to grow in life, you need new avenues. Many a times it is seen that you are dealing with the same products, you are dealing with the same brand, you are dealing with the same services as a professional. Like I am dealing with VAT. Many a times I feel that if you are able to listen to your clients, what they are doing, what they are not doing, you could realize that today a client requires a valuation, today a client requires an FDI investment, today a client requires multiple location registrations to be done. I could basically do that. But how would I know that? I would know when I also spend time in listening to a client. And for that, most of us have got 24 hours, right? Anybody has got more than 24 hours?
No.
And this is going to be a challenge of that 24 hours, how do I use it? Many of you would always wonder that Sanjay always comes here for Jito for every small program also. Where does he practice at all? We can basically delegate. We can basically use our contact, we can use a team wherein we delegate most of our job, and you can create time. And that time what is created by you, if you are going to listen to people, one thing is that, have you ever found offensive if somebody listens to you? When you are talking and somebody is listening, have you found it offensive?
No.
But when you are talking, how many people have been offended about you? Many. And when others are talking to you, do you feel offended?
Sometimes.
At times. We feel when the other, like, Mahesh is feeling not. Okay, you do feel offended, right? So, Basically, by listening, one, you are satisfying his ego to say that, well, you are a good listener. And that's also going to help you. And that guy is going to praise you later. You Mahesh both sunta very well. Okay. Then, it will also give you new opportunities. Like when you meet different people. Like, Anup is here. Yeah, Anup is there. He had come down to my office. Normally, any work is to be given, I give it to my partners or my colleagues and basically distribute it across. So when I was sitting with Anup, and basically we were talking about what he does. That's my basic job in the office, only to listen to what the clients are doing, what my friends are doing across. And there I came across that he was talking about creating a game. Right, Anup?
Yeah.
And what does the game cost? Anybody can guess here other than Anup? He's trying to create a game. So what does the game cost? Anyone? 1 crore? What game is it, Anup? Video game? So
it's a mobile and PC platform game.
It's a mobile basic platform game. So do you know what does it cost to create that game? It goes up to 600 hours, right? Non-stop? Yeah, 600 hours. 10 lakhs? This is not your market. A few crores? Something above? Anybody? The cost of creating the game, not of selling it, not creating a brand across. What would be the cost?
A lot of time. 625
Well,
almost all the price for the
No, I'm not talking about how much it charge, they charge you for playing the game. I'm talking about how much is the cost of making the game, creating the game. Yeah, hello? 1 second, hello? He's talking about the mobile game, not the PC game, right?
PC game, not the mobile.
He's talking about the PC game, not the mobile game. When he was talking to me, he said, to make a basic preview of this game, it costs around 20 crores. And if you want to make the game per se, it costs around 1,200 crores. No, you stop playing games. Okay, you can still play the game, but don't play games. So what I'm trying to say is that when you meet different people, somebody came to me and said that we want to basically go into the media field and all, we were talking for long. Then he asked the advantages, disadvantages. Then they said, okay, fine, this is a good opportunity to get into the field of media. So basically what you can do is that when you meet different people, what I'm trying to say is learn to listen, and trust me, you will get lots of ideas. I'm sure most of the ideas that Mr. Mahendra Chauhan has got in pharmaceuticals is not his own ideas. Right, sir? It's all listening to other people and then fine-tuning those mistakes what those people have done, and then you create your own ideas or you create your own success stories which are going to be very useful. Keep it cool, live up to your promise and focus on the customer, and this will build what we call as brand loyalty. How many of us lose our temper when the customer comes to us? We have to be cool. After all, what, he's going to pay us for it? Yes or no? Today there may be a huge demand for your product, so you are waiting. But every product, believe me, today it is no more a seller's market, it's going to be a buyer's market. Even in the service sector, if you believe that I'm the king, I'm the best in this particular subject, please forget it. This is not going to be a service provider's market, it's going to be a service receiver's market. And when you're talking about a service receiver's market, today there may be a little gap between the service providers and the service receivers. Good service providers are less. But believe me, that was a gap even 40 years back when you had about goods. But today it is now a pure buyer's market, not a seller's market. Earlier when I had to book a Lambretta, I had to book any scooters, I had to wait for around 5 years, 6 years, and I had a premium paid to me for the bookings what I have done. Today, off the shelf, I can get 10, 20, 50, 100 varieties of scooters and vehicles across which I want to buy across. And today, it is totally a buyer's market. The same thing is going to be with the professionals also. It is going to be a service receiver's market, not a service provider's market. So you have to keep yourself cool. You have to deliver your goods on time. You cannot say, "Aap wait karo, mere paas time nahi hai." One time, two times, you listen. If today Rajendra Gandhi has a problem on VAT matters and he comes to me and I say, "Ek mahine ke baad milte Rajendra bhai, mere paas time nahi hai," he would have got another consultant doing the job and closing it across. I still remember my colleague basically delayed giving an opinion by 4 days. It went to another consultant, he gave it in 24 hours time, he charged 3 lakh rupees for that opinion. My client was willing to pay 3 lakh rupees for this opinion, but we said it will take 1 week's time. He went to another chartered accountant, got it in one day's time, equally competent. So basically your deliverables would matter. You'll have to understand who your client is and what you're doing, and what you promise, you better deliver. And that's going to keep a loyalty to you. There was a time around 40 years back, 30 years back, 20 years back, if I gone to X chartered accountant, I would never move my file. Right, Manubhai? Today, majority of us would not look at this. We would say, this man can deliver me today, there is no loyalty towards the other person. The next generation is not going to be loyal to you, they're going to only see what is the benefit I'm getting, what is the services I'm getting, and what is I'm exactly going to get the net result or the bottom line of it. And this is going to be a very important issue, particularly if you're a professional, particularly if you're a dealer, and particularly as an individual also. This loyalty is something which is going to be very useful for you. Deliverables on time, don't bite what you cannot chew. Many of us, even in social organizations, we see lots of great personalities in social organizations. How many of us are able to deliver? We have to learn to say no. And we have to basically chew only what we can eat. Otherwise, this is going to be a difficult issue for us, and that is going to spoil your brand. Because ultimately what people would say, Sanjay ko kuch bhi kaam diya, bolta kar lunga, he doesn't deliver. Rather say, no, I can't deliver it. What is wrong? You would not be creating a brand loss. I remember I had been around 15 years back to a company called Praxair. And I had approached them, and once we were talking to them, and they said that, Sanjay, we've got a huge work to be done on outsourcing, so can you take it up? I said, sorry, I don't have the capabilities to deliver it now. I can start after 3 months because I need a team to be prepared. He said, by saying no to me, you are losing business today. Think over. And it was a big account. I'm talking about 97, 98 when we went to Praxair. And the business at that time was around 30, 40 lakhs of billing. That was large as far as chartered accountants are concerned in 96, 97. I told him, sorry, I can't take it up. He said, you are mad. I'm giving you an offer because I know you're capable of delivering it. You're saying a no to me. I said, sir, today if I take it up and I don't deliver, this no is going to remain for me all your life. But today, if I say you no, and tomorrow if I approach you again, and I say, I can deliver it now, can you give it to me? You will be the first person to give it to me. So I would like to create a sort of a branding of myself to say that I will only take up that job what I can deliver, otherwise I will learn to say no. If I'm not able to deliver, trust me, my brand value falls very bad, and you would know what I mean. And if your plan A fails, many a times when you're trying to create a brand, you're trying to create, like a simple thing. Today in this audience, if I have to give a joke across or I have to speak a joke across, all the jokes everybody would not laugh, right? There are some jokes which people would, all of you would laugh together, but sometimes some people would not understand it. Some people would find it, I've already heard it across, you would not understand. You always have your plan A, but you've got another 25 alphabets, and you can always use your plan B, plan C, plan D, and you should not give up in life. Try new ideas before it's stale. This was one of the reasons that I took up this talk also, because I thought, let me try my hands on branding also and try to improve on this, because ultimately VAT is getting rusted now. Okay. It's getting rusted because everything is on systems. There's no opinions coming in. Everybody's aware of what the law is going to be. So I have to look out at new areas. The same way in your personalities also, you have to look out at new areas, the way you present yourself. Every day you cannot wear the same dress and go to a seminar or a conference or a party, right? You have to change your dress. Just like you change your dress, you'll also have to change your ideas. Create free time so that you identify new projects and opportunities. I think this is one area where most of us lack. How many of us actually have time here? Rajendra Bhai, please note down the names. These are all people who can deliver a lot for you. He's got four times the time. Believe me, many times when we talk to young kids also, they always say, "Hamare paas time nahi hai, uncle. We have to go to college, we have to do this, we have to do that, we don't have time." I believe that this is one of the biggest lies we are telling ourselves. All of us have time. It is only how we structure ourselves, how we delegate ourselves, how we follow across. And believe me, you can create time, and time created is what? I'll just give you a simple example. Today, if you have got around 365 days, you work 365 days, you get paid for 365 days, right? Now, if the best athletic today for 100 meters race, how much time does it take? around 8.76 was the world record, 8.72 seconds is the world record. Our chairman has also come from Apex. I'm sorry, I didn't see you, sir. Tejrat sir is present here. I acknowledge his presence here. Sir, I request you to please come in the front, sir. Okay, I'm sorry, I didn't see him. Okay, it takes how much? 8.72 seconds, etc., to be the world's fastest man. And most of the time, he would reach at around 9 seconds, right? Today, you start practicing running. How many of us could reach at 11 seconds? 100 meters. Probably, yes, we could reach. Probably, 11, 11.5 seconds, we should be able to complete the 100 meters, except a few of them who are above 50s and all. But otherwise, you could basically reach at 11, 11.5 or 12 seconds max. The difference between 9 seconds and 12 seconds is how much? 3 seconds. Right? And the 3 seconds, if you see the difference of 3 seconds and 9 seconds, the difference is only around 33% on 9 seconds or 25% on 12 seconds. That's the difference, 25%. That 25% extra time, if you are able to create in your life, you can be a distinction between the 6 billion or 5 billion people in the world and the one man who achieved this particular topic. And that 25% of time creation is the real challenge for us. And believe me, friends, all of us have the potential not to reach at 8.72 seconds. Definitely, no, we don't have the potential, because everybody cannot hit a 6 like Rohit Sharma or Sachin Tendulkar can hit. But believe me, that we can definitely create time for ourselves if we are better planned, if we are better delegated, and we know how to manage our jobs well. I'm sure we can create the time. And that 25% time distinguishes you between a brand and an average person. So if you want to be really a brand, you should be visible. If you are able to do many things at a particular time, I think what you require is time. And that time all of us have is 24 hours a day. And many of us have one bad habit. Maine ye koshish to kiya tha, but main failure ho gaya. You ask any successful person in the world. Today, if Mr. Gandhi is one of the largest industrialists in the Jain community in Bangalore today, and if you ask him that every time you did business, were you successful, Mr. Gandhi? This 3 times of failure to 1 time of success is a bare minimum, I would say. In fact, I also tell my staff or my articles who are young students who come to us for CA, that if you see that Sanjay has been successful with every audit, every work, every appeal we filed, it is wrong. We are successful maximum around 20% of the works which we take up or new challenges we take. The routine jobs, we are 100% successful. Routine jobs, we have to be successful because that is set up as a system and that does not require creativity. But if you are talking about new ventures, nobody talks about the 80% losses that we have done. I was surprised when in one of the platforms when I and Mr. Gandhi were together, he spoke about his loss. And that was shocking for me. Most of us do not speak about where we made failures. We only talk about our success. So when you see a shining star, you normally try to say that, wow, so much of success he's got. He's been a very lucky person. You have not seen the number of failures that he has. And believe me, today, Salman Khan may be a great brand, a great personality, a great individual, but even his movies flop. Amitabh was a great brand. He was the number one star, but when his movie started falling, he also became bankrupt. After that, he changed again. That's a different thing. So failures are very much a part. Who are the people who has never failed in life?
Those who never tried.
The person who has never attempted it. So if you want to be successful, you have to be having a part of failures with you. Recognize people who have supported you. I think this is the place where many of us lose on our plan. If you are able to recognize the people who have brought you to the particular level, what you are, the stage, what you are there across, that is going to help you grow in life. For an example, I would say that today if X has referred me a client and I call him back and say thanks for doing it, next time he'll be motivated to refer me 3 more clients. If I'm going to ignore him, he's going to ignore me also and not refer me anything else. If today, if I give a good business opportunity to Mr. Gandhi or anybody present here, you are going to recognize me and say that fine, isne mere ko business diya hai, maybe uska dhyan rakhunga. And I think he just thanks me, the next time I feel like recommending him again. But if I do not get a call, what happens? I think today, this is an area where if you want to have a very strong brand, your real brand ambassadors are the people who have been recommending you earlier, who have been supporting you earlier, because they are the people who can further project your brand better. Otherwise, many times what we have seen, the man who is promoted XYZ earlier, he himself is the biggest critic of that particular person because he feels he is neglected. So this is one area where we can look across, and no job is a small job. Don't wait for someone else to come and do it because the job is below your status. Let it be your organization, let it be your NGO, wherever you are part of it. Many times we feel, HR, make your rakho, this is my status. Nahin. It's time that we come and do it ourselves. And believe me, that the more simple you are, the more decent you are, the more humble you are, your brand value is going to be much higher as far as your personal are concerned. Today, even your house, if today you are going to say your children, ki main tumhara baap hoon, pani leke aa, glass rakke ja, today your children are not going to listen to you. Yeah. Are they going to listen?
No.
He'll say, baap honge aap apne ghar mein, though he's talking in your same house. So today you have to change your culture to say that, fine, I am his father, but let me do my job. There's nothing which is big or small. And today when he sees you polishing his shoes, he will come and say, Papa, can I polish your shoes? So today, this is something is going to be an appreciation which will come, and appreciate all kinds of work that comes your way. Many a times, what happens is, once you get a small brand across, you always feel that, ye kaam mere stature ka nahi hai, main kyun karun, ye mera nahi hai, ye wo nahi hai, mere ko mere level ka job dijiye. I think this is one of the biggest disadvantages we also see when people start branding themselves in social organizations. I think today we have to come out of this particular philosophy and say that no job is small job. But that doesn't mean that you ask me to come to your house to clean your toilets. No job is small job, but then you don't call me for a small job. But if there's a necessity of doing a small job, I don't mind doing it. But I'm not called for only doing a small job. And this is also something that you'll have to maintain your stature also. Just being too humble may sometimes also crumble your brand image also. So you'll have to be a little more strategic on that level. But if a time comes that it's a necessity, do it. Now this is something. Be humble at the same time, learn to say no when you require. And these are the don'ts which you should not do. Don't raise yourself. I've been doing that, so don't follow it. Raise yourself. Many a times what happens is, you always say, I did this, maine ye kiya, maine wo kiya. Nobody is interested in those glorious stories. Unless and until, if it is a Chetan Bhagat or an Obama coming across and telling that this is what I did. Because there are 100% branded success stories with them. Otherwise, normally, we are not interested in saying what you have done. So basically, don't praise yourself. Absorb what is useless. Reject what is useless. And what is specifically your own. Basically, this is an area. Avoid criticizing a person rather than tell him very respectfully. One of the major brand clashes which happen, when two persons of the same branding in the same organization start criticizing each other, is the place where you have this particular problem. If at all you feel that I do not like Dinesh for certain things he is told, I would rather take Dinesh in the side and tell him that Dinesh, look, this is something wrong. Why don't you change on this? Or I feel that you could do it much better. He's definitely going to change. But in front of 100 people, if I'm going to say, Dinesh, what you're doing is wrong, don't keep the bottle like this, throw it in the dustbin and come. He's telling to hell with you. And that is the places where the clashes also come, and this is the area where we have to go. This is one other area where we actually spoil our brand. I approach a person for a particular job. He says me no. What I start doing? I start criticizing that person. I start avoiding that person. I say, itne baar main gaya tha, kabhi kuch kaam nahi diya, ye aadmi barobar nahi hai. Right? Many times we do that. On the other hand, if the person doesn't give you a job at the initial stages for whatever you have gone or whatever it is done, or he doesn't recognize you, just don't ignore him. Still be good. I still remember a classic case of Amitabh Bachchan. Amitabh was the topmost star at that particular time, and he went to a particular studio. And Amitabh being Amitabh did not carry the ID card or he did not carry the pass to enter into the studio. And the security guy said, please stop. You are not allowed to come inside. He said, why? He said, aapke paas pass nahi hai. He said, main Amitabh Bachchan hoon, meri shooting chal rahi hai, I have to go inside. And those days mobiles were not there. So he said, no, I do not know you. Amitabh could have got that watchman fired. What Amitabh did, he told sorry, he sent a slip across, he called the director across, the director took him across inside, and after that, every time he used to go there, he used to wish the gate man. What happened? After that, that became a sort of a personality which was exhibited to the world that Amitabh is such a simple personality. That creates your brand. But if you would have snubbed him and removed it, fine, the gate man would have lost his job, finished, it's all fine. But what I'm trying to say to you is that would he have got the class or the image or the thing that his fans want him? When a fan considers you to be God, they believe that everything you do is right. Similarly, when you create a brand value, you also see to it that you don't snub people. The same person who would have probably rejected you or not given you business, there is a strong possibility that he would give you business later. He would try to observe you. And this is one of the examples I've seen in most of the professionals today. Most of the professionals today, normally when we approach a particular client, when we have started our profession, we do not get the client. Right, Mehta sir? Why? Because people would like to observe you, try to see whether you are going to sustain in practice or not. They would like to see whether your quality of job is good or not, and they would come to you after 3 to 5 years. So the moment you snub them across, you would lose your basically branding and they would not refer you again. So try to appreciate them. There should be a reason why they have not come to you. Either there was no work which you require, either there was no product which they wanted to buy from you, or the third thing could be that probably he needs some time to judge whether the quality what you are giving is really right or wrong. Then, what are your target audience? You have to select the top what the right person wants. I cannot talk about cricket to a lady who doesn't understand cricket. I cannot talk about saris to somebody else other than Prakash Ji Singhvi, and if it is a man. Because Prakash Ji Singhvi understands saris, but I don't understand, but Dinesh may not understand saris, except the ones which his wife or others wear. Okay, and what matters? The right media, the right timing, the right message. Don't lose your temper, tone down your voice down, and restrain your aggression. I think these are some of the important qualities if you want to remain a brand. One is creating your brand, the second is sustaining your brand. If today, however big a brand is today, however important the person is today, if he's going to lose his tempers, if he's going to use a harsh tone on you, are you going to respect that personality? Today, if Rajendra Ji Gandhi is the president, and today he uses a harsh tone on you, probably yes, you will listen to him. But tomorrow when he's not the president, would you listen to him? No. But if he has always used a good tone with you, he's maintained his temper, he's not been very aggressive, he's listened to your suggestions as a president, even when he's not a president, you will listen to him for the fact that you respect him as a brand, Mr. RG. And the right messages, the right timings, right media, I think, what's the time now?
We have to finish in 5 minutes.
150. I think we shift, this would go on. I think the mail, this could be sent as a mail to all of you. We'll just go. Visibility is an important area. Many times at many places we try to be we try to be visible at wrong times, wrong sessions, asking wrong questions. These are also the areas where visibility is important. Try to see that you are visible, but also you don't make yourself over visible. Teamwork is an important aspect. Everywhere you don't say it is I, we say it is we. Then take a feedback from those who matter the most, the people whom you respect, the people whom you admire. Take feedbacks, rectify yourself, correct yourself. There's always a day when you know that you have made a mistake and you can basically rectify it. And what makes you unique makes you successful. If you're going to package yourself differently, many of the products are the same. The packaging is what matters. And if the packaging is right, if the personalities are the same, the human beings are the same, everybody has the same soul. Everybody has a soul which has the same knowledge. But with your karma philosophies, they say, it is attached with too many things which you are not able to understand your knowledge or the Himmat would be a better person to talk on this. And most of us, when we talk about our own brand, we see that we are a very large brand. Whereas most of the other people see you as a negative in the large brand. The real brand is what you believe is your brand and what the other person also accepts you as a brand. And that is going to be your actual brand. Most of us believe that we are very good in everything. You ask your spouse, you ask your children, they'll tell you what bad you are in many things. So this is what it is. And the last and not the least, branding is not a one-night stand. Ye saath janmo ka saath hai. It should be a continuous process, long-term, every day, every minute. And believe me, after years and years of creating your brand, creating a strong image, One Nityananda Swami's one CD comes out, he is finished. Right? Because that one image of his got hurt because of this. Or one rape allegations against Sasaram Bapu, what followers he had was huge, is gone because of this particular factor. So it is not going to be that you create your brand today and forget it. It's not going to be that it's basically that it's a continuous process which we have to do it across. And this is the way we have to work on our brand. And every day, every minute, you are being watched. And as personalities you are concerned, believe me, branding is the easiest job because others do it for you. But to make others your brand ambassadors, it's going to be a Herculean task. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Let's here have a big round of applause for him. I'm sure they were wonderful. Let's hear. Were they competent enough? I'm sure you all have are going to go back enriched about your brands. How do you build them? How do you improvise on them? Were you convinced with this session, friends? Yes. Thank you. A quick question and answer session for 5 minutes. Those of you who would want to question, please name whom you want to question, and then I can ask the questions for the same.
If you're asking about the lunch, you can ask Mahesh about it. What kind of lunch?
Anyone?
We were crystal clear, I guess so, but they didn't understand anything.
Any questions?
Can we link the question of his to your new program of the marriage?
Yeah.
Is it allowed?
Anything related to branding, you can do it.
Branding. Excuse me.
Branding.
ब्रांडिंग में बताया कि अ पर्सन आई विल मिक्स इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी या नो प्रॉब्लम वी अंडरस्टैंड बोथ
ओके थैंक यू आपने बताया कि अ पर्सन हैज टू बी हम्बल
या
वो बड़ा हो जाए तो भी सिंपल रहे
यस सर
एंड यू सेड दैट जैसे एग्जांपल दिया चेयर लगाए ही इज अ फादर ही कैन नॉट कमांड एंड नाउ यू पुट अ प्रोग्राम ऑफ ग्रुप मैरिज
या
आई वुड लाइक आई हैव आई विल टेक दिस करेज टू आस्क How many of your senior Jito members have committed to this kind of an arrangement when it comes to their managers at home? Responsibility should start from the top. I'm taking this courage. Don't take it personally. I have my own issues with this kind of an arrangement. I see it is not very practical. बहुत कोशिशें हो चुकी हैं कि इतने ही आइटम हो, उतने ही आइटम हो. One of my brother's marriage, I went to a panel. I asked them. 31 items, क्या क्या आ सकता है क्या क्या नहीं आ सकता है आई इम्प्लीमेंटेड इट इन वन ऑफ माई ब्रदर्स मैरिज आई वॉज द इंचार्ज एंड आफ्टर सम टाइम आई वेंट टू अ मैरिज ऑफ वन ऑफ द पैनलिस्ट एंड आई फाइंड 80 आइटम्स व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ मैसेज इज दिस देयर हैज टू बी अ कमिटमेंट फ्रॉम द टॉप रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी शुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द टॉप ऑर्डर अगर वो करते हैं तो कल मैं इस पे कमिट करूंगा आज मैं नहीं करूंगा
See, let us understand one thing. I'll give you my personal opinion on this. I will not give you as a Jito member. Can I give you my personal opinion? Number one, this is a trend which we want to create. I think Ranjit Bhai will agree with that. This is not going to be something by force or by mandate that you should do it like this. Okay, now the thing is that in a family of 5 members, you have different opinions at home. In Jito also, you may have a few members who may not agree. But we will implement this only with those people who are agreeable to it, number one. And second thing is that you'll also have to understand that majority of us agree, that is the reason we are taking it forward. Now, when we say we agree, it doesn't mean that we agree on a platform, but not in real reality. When we say we agree, that we all are concerned today. If we are not concerned today of saving the expenses, then we wouldn't have thought about this. I think, and my chairman, All India Apex chairman himself has stood up and said that I confirm that I'm going to follow this. Right?
This is what I want to
do. So I think once the head says yes, the body follows what the nervous system takes you back to your brain.
Let us see.
Yeah. And this 21 items in Jito meetings you have already passed, that in Jito meetings whenever food is going to be there, it's not going to exceed 21 items.
Another thing I want to tell you, can I?
Yes, sir.
We can some other meeting on this, I will put a few more.
I would request Ranjit ji to have a discussion with all the members, call them across who would like to give the feedback so that we can have it in a session wherein we do it better.
Sir, for this one, we keep only questions related to branding, and then if any other points are there regarding this one, we can have one more talk, maybe off.
permission for asking.
No, there is no problem. He has given permission. ये एक्चुअली समाज सुधार के लिए ऐसा नहीं है कि अपने को यही करना है. समय के हिसाब से कई बार चेंज होते हैं और जब जब अपन समय के हिसाब से पब्लिक के हिसाब से उनकी जो इच्छाएं हैं उनको जानकारी रखते हुए यदि सुधार करेंगे ना 100% सक्सेसफुल होगा. मैं तो एक छोटा समाज जो आवर समाज का है उनके गांव की शादी का देख रहा हूं. आज से 30 साल पहले जब शुरू किया था ना काफी लोग नहीं मानते थे और आज वहां का बड़े से बड़ा उसी को पद चिन्ह पे चल के अपना फायदा कर रहे हैं. एक शादी 41,000 में मेरे ख्याल से यहाँ पर अपना वीडियोग्राफर कम से कम 2 लाख में आता होगा. एक बच्ची की शादी यदि 41,000-51,000 में हो सकती है कितना भला कितना फायदा हुआ समाज का. हाँ जैसे अभी मेरे को मालूम नहीं था 21 आइटम का तो बट 21 आइटम है. यदि हो सकता है सबकी अभी ऐसा नहीं 21 नहीं साहब 2-5 आइटम और भी बढ़ा तो समाज के साथ में अपन को जाना ही. मेरे गांव का खुद का है पूरे बंदे से होता है इसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. बड़ा आदमी होने दो छोटा आदमी दो हम आम आदमी को लेके चलेंगे तो ये पालन होगा. और हम नहीं चाहते कि हम किसी के ऊपर कठोरता से ये लेवे करके अपनी इच्छा है जितना फायदा हो सके समाज का ही होगा ना. एक गांव में मैं गया था एक्चुअली संजय जी अपना बाकरा रोड की वो शादी में शरद के वहां पर वो एरिया के अंदर उस दिन 18 शादियां थी और एक एक वहां पर क्या है जितना ज्यादा मीठा करता ना कंधो एक उसको ज्यादा पैसा दिया जाता है. हर घर के अंदर शादी और हर घर के अंदर कंदोई आए 4-5 लाख रुपए देके. और फाइनली खाने वाले कितने थे सराउंडिंग में 350 लोग 18 लोगों के अंदर 90 लाख खाली कंदोई के लिए हैं और खाने वाले 350 लोग. और यहाँ भी जो अपन शादी देख रहे हैं पैलेस के अंदर 30% तो कॉमन पब्लिक की वो इधर भी जाती उधर भी जाती इधर भी और फाइनली कैटरिंग वाले के घर भरते हैं. तो ये जो जीटो से हमारे बंधुओं ने जो अपना कदम उठाया है सराहनीय कदम है और हम सब इसमें सहयोग देंगे तो समाज का फायदा है और वो ही पैसा हम समाज के दूसरे काम में भी लगा सकते हैं. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू. रिक्वेस्टिंग क्विक क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू प्लानिंग टू एनी ऑफ दीज टू स्पीकर्स प्लीज. या वन ओवर देयर.
गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. Can I ask a question to Rajendra Ji Gandhi because he already has a brand.
On branding? Yes.
On branding, yes.
He's become another trainer.
Alright. Sir, I'd like to ask you, let's say tomorrow you want to start a brand, okay, on the same lines, probably of your product or any other product. How difficult or how big a challenge is it for guys like us to control the cost? Let's say I want to create a product for the masses and for which I'll have to control the cost a lot. So today if I start up something new, how difficult is it for people like us who start something new today to keep the costs effective enough to compete with the already existing brands?
Well, there is no direct straight answer. But if there is a determination, there is nothing difficult. So it may be a little logical kind of answer and not a direct answer. But still I will try to answer you this. See, brands are built based on the investment. Investments are not only in terms of absolute the capital that you employ, there is the cash capital that you employ. I told you that commitment investment that you need to do is what is the basic capital for building brands. It's not that you blow up some few money like Flipkart is today investing and acquiring. What is it Flipkart doing today? The valuation what I mentioned was the future earning potential. They are investing in acquiring consumers. What is it they are trying to do? आज अपन एक दुकान जाके खरीदते हैं उस आदत को बदलने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. दे आर चेंजिंग दिस. दे आर ट्राइंग ब्रिंगिंग पीपल ऑनलाइन. क्यों कैसे लेके आ रहे हैं? फर्स्ट थिंग दे आर प्रॉमिसिंग ऑल दैट क्वालिटी सर्विस एंड ऑल्सो प्रॉमिसिंग यू एक्स्ट्रॉर्डनरी प्राइसिंग मतलब विच इज नॉट नॉर्मल. मतलब आदत डालने की बात है. सो दे आर इन्वेस्टिंग. सो यू शुड ऑल्सो नो योर बिजनेस साइज. How much you can invest? You need not invest like Flipkart does. You can take a little more longer time, but you will surely build your brand. The basic capital that is required is the commitment that yes, my customer is the one by whom the brand can be built. You, me, your capital can never build brands. I'm not sure whether you really.
Alright, thank you.
addition to this, see, I think as an entrepreneur, if you want to start, first thing you need to look at is a gap. Is there a gap which probably if you are comparing with his brand, he's not able to serve any brand for that matter or any product category for that matter, you need to first find a gap. Is there a gap existing in the market? There are set of people not buying any kind of product in that particular product category. So if you do a little bit of innovation, that can also go a long way. Innovation itself is a big brand in itself. That is to bring big brand promise. You can start with a low cost as well. So that's also a possibility.
Basically one depends on the industry. Like today, a product like Coke or Pepsi, they spend substantial money in branding. Not because they want to brand the product, but they want the brand of the other person to be subdued a little. Okay, now there is no thumb rule as to say how much money should I spend. It's basically an opportunity which you get across. Like today, Coke spent a huge amount in branding one of the cricket tournaments. And what Pepsi did, they were not able to win the bet over that, it went to Coke. So they came out with nothing official about it. And they created a bigger brand than what Coke was there at that particular time, with this particular tagline. So I think money, what you spend, is different. It is, as Mr. Gandhi said, that it is the customers which are going to create your brand. You cannot create it. They spend money, you will spend on the visibility. Like you had this shirts which Hrithik Roshan was doing for Arvind Mills, Camden shirts. They spent a lot of money on the plan, but was it able to sustain? No. What was the reason? There was a product deficiency in that particular level. So that is the reason that Tamarind was not successful. So I think just spending money on brand is not the criteria. How much you spend is not the criteria. It is whether it is reaching the right segment. I think that's a criteria. I think today the brand on the upper ladder, or what is it called as? Urban ladder. They are doing it only through the Facebook, and they have created a very strong brand today. And I think it's under the valuation. Himak could add on to it.
The only addition is that yesterday, Ratan Tata has invested in Urban Ladder.
Honda is a good example.
Very important announcement again. Mahavir Jisa cut it. Is he outside? Magnanimity of this man, he has just informed Tejas sir that he wants to go from being a patent to an FCP. Thanks, Mahavir sir. And thanks to, of course, Tejas ji. I cannot thank him. He is the reason for all this, but he is motivated him and voluntarily wanted to. So again, my request to you all friends is whoever wants to move up the ladder, and this is what we all do, unless we go to the next level, and all pattern members who want to upgrade, you're all welcome, and I think you should take a step. And thank you for this wonderful morning. Thanks both of you. And
just for 2 more minutes. Friends, please do settle just for 2 more minutes. Any more questions, please? I think all of you all do agree they were clear enough with their concepts and their delegation. We thank you so much, Sanjay and Himal. Thank you very much. And before we wind up this, requesting Surendra to please come over to give over the vote of thanks.
Thank you, friends. It's a wonderful audience, even sitting at till at 2:15. And branding is a vast and difficult subject. I'd like to thank Mr. Sanjay Dhariwal and Mr. Himal Jain, and also unknown speaker today, star speaker of Rajendra Gandhi. I'd like to thank on behalf of all of you and sharing his own experiences. And also I'd like to thank all organizing committee members. And I request all of you to have your lunch, which is organized at the basement of this building. Thank you one and all.